Let's take a look at an example about continuity together. So the directions here say to determine if the function is continuous at the given point. So here we have f of x, and it's defined as a piecewise function. So f of x equals 3x squared plus 7 if x is less than 2, and f of x equals sine of x if x is greater than 2. And the point that we're trying to look at is x equals 2. So we want to determine if the function is continuous at that point. Okay, so basically when you're given a problem like this, you simply want to go down your list of continuity criteria and check each one off one by one. So the first one that people usually check is if the function is defined at the point in question, just because that's the easiest one to check. And if it's not, then you're done. So let's start with that. Okay, so I'm asking myself, does f of 2 exist? Okay, well, look back at my piecewise function. I have one piece that is defined for x less than 2, and another piece that is defined for x greater than 2. But nowhere do I see the function existing for x equals 2. So I see right away that f of 2 doesn't exist. Therefore, f of x is not continuous at x equals 2, because it fails one of the criteria for continuity. Okay, so I'm not actually going to let you off that easy. I just wanted to show you right off the bat an easy example of where the function is not continuous. But let's look at a more realistic problem, one that you're more likely to see on an exam. Same directions here, different function, different point. So we've got the point g of x, which is also defined as a piecewise function. So g of x equals x squared minus 2x minus 8 all over x minus 4 if x is not equal to 4, but g of x equals 7 if x equals 4. And the point that I'm trying to determine the continuity at is x equals 4. So we're going to start this problem out in the same way I did the previous example. I basically want to go down my list of continuity criteria. So the first question I'm going to ask myself, is f of 4 defined? Or does f of 4 exist? Okay, so let me look at my piecewise function. So I'm looking for the piece that includes x equal to 4. So that's this piece right here. So I see that f of 4 is defined, right? F of 4 equals 7. Okay, so the first criteria is met. So I keep going. Second criteria, does the limit exist? So does the limit as x goes to 4 of g of x exist? Okay, so this criteria is a little bit more involved to check. We're actually going to have to take the limit of this function as x goes to 4 and see what it is. Okay, so I'm looking at the limit as x goes to 4. Remember, I don't actually care what the function is doing right at 4. I'm only concerned about what's happening near 4. So when I take the limit, I'm actually going to be taking the limit of this top piece here, of this rational function. So to answer this question, I want the limit as x goes to 4 of x squared minus 2x minus 8 over x minus 4. Okay, so now we need to remember how to take limits, right? So let's start just by plugging in 4 to the top and the bottom and see what happens. So if I plug in 4 to the top, I'm going to get 4 squared, which is 16. So 16 minus 8 minus 8. So that's 0 on top. And then I would get 0 on the bottom as well. So 0 over 0. Remember from a few lessons ago that this tells me I need to do more algebra to figure out the limit. Now this problem, being a rational function, looks like it would be a good candidate for trying to factor. So let's try and factor the numerator. Okay, so I see that this is going to factor into x minus 4, x plus 2. And then, of course, I still have x minus 4 on the bottom. So I see I have a common factor in the top and bottom, so I'm going to cancel out that factor. And since I'm only looking at the limit as x goes to 4, and not at the point itself, it's okay that I've sort of redefined the function at 4. Well, now I've gotten myself to the point where I have a really simple limit. So this is just the limit as x goes to 4 of x plus 2. So that's just going to be 4 plus 2, which equals 6. Great. So we've answered this question, does the limit at as x goes to 4 exist? And we found that it does. So, yes. That means we only have one more question to answer. Okay, the final question. Does the function value at 4 equal the limit as x goes to 4? Okay, so what was the function value at 4? Well, if we scroll back up here, we see that it was 7. And what about the limit? Well, that was 6. So those are not equal. So unfortunately, this criteria is not met. So that means that my function is not continuous. So therefore, g of x is not continuous at x equals 4. It was pretty close though, right? The only thing that would have had to change to make this function continuous is g of x would have to equal 6 at x equals 4. And if that were the case, then this would have been continuous. But it's not.